A few years ago, I did a series on my YouTube channel of interesting facts from every episode of The Office from every season. And ever since then, I've been wanting to do this to other shows that I love. And after a 2-year break, I thought, what the hell? Let's do this again. So the show I'm doing interesting facts on every episode from every season now is Married with Children. Married with Children is a sitcom that follows the Bundy family. No relation to Ted Bundy. Better, but still horrible. Married with Children ran on the Fox network for 10 years between 1987 to 1997 for a grand total of 11 seasons. Like my Office series, every fact I'll be getting from every episode comes from the Wikia page itself. So this might not be 100% accurate, but let's just hope. But before we get started, I need your help. The next show I decided to cover on my channel is The Golden Girls, but I have two options. Lately, I've been reading Golden Girls, An Unauthorized Look Behind the Lanai by Jim Gallucci, and I honestly recommend this if you love the show. After starting to read this, I thought it'd be cool to do a 4-part series on 100 interesting facts I learned from this book. Now, will I get 100? I do not know, but I'm aiming for 100. This is where you guys come in. Should I do a 4-part series on the 100 things I learned from the Golden Girls Forever, An Unauthorized Look Behind the Lanai book? Or a 7-part interesting facts from each episode of the Golden Girls series? Go to my community tab or comment the vote. So today, let's take a look at interesting facts from each episode for Married with Children, Season 8. While the ball is in the air during Peggy's free throw shot in a tisket a tasket, can Peggy make a basket? Clyde Drexler thinks, hey, if we had her instead of Ainge, we'd have won the championship. This is referenced to the NBA Finals in 1992 when the Portland Trail Blazers played against the Chicago Bulls. Clyde Drexler and Danny Ainge, members of the Portland Trail Blazers, lost during Game 6. Danny Ainge would then go on to sign to be on the Phoenix Suns a few weeks later. Although Al's friend and Hood and the boys Skippy would die in the following season's Dud Ball, the actor who plays him, Chuck L.E. Fever, would attend his funeral in Dud Ball as Speedy. The clips of Bud getting hit in Bud Bundy's greatest hits and Proud to Be Your Bud are from Kelly Bounces Back, What I Did for Love, Movie Show, and The Dateless Amigo. J.J. Johnston, who plays Jefferson's friend Louie in Luck of the Bundys, played Happy, a toy store salesman in the mall where the shoe store is in Where's the Boss from Season 1. The actor who plays the moderator in Banking on Marcy, Bo Billingsley, would play Reverend Hightower in the final seasons, A Bundy Thanksgiving, 3 seasons later. In No Chick and No Check, Kelly describes her date as right behind Heathcliff and the late Miles Davis. Miles Davis, who was a world-renowned trumpeter's 2-year anniversary of his death, was around the time this episode was filmed. In the original airing for Take My Wife, Please, it ended with the Bundy's death and the village people dancing to YMCA in the Bundy house, while Al inhales the toxic fumes from Kelly's spray canister. While it is just a still frame with YMCA playing during the credits on the Season 8 DVD release, you can see the ending on Hulu. Episode 8 is called Scared Single. Besides being the title of a 1973 documentary, this is a reference to something Al said in Season 6's Rites of Passage. In that episode, Al said that years before, a group of inmates were sent to the shoe store in a program called Scared Rich, and an inmate left in tears. He then goes on to say how too bad they didn't have a Scared Single program. The actress who plays Bubble Double D in No Ma'am, Lisa Boyle, would play Kelly's friend Fawn in Love Conquers Al 2 seasons later. Episode 10 is called Dances with Wheezy. Wheezy is the nickname that George Jefferson gave his wife Louise on the classic 1970s/80s sitcom, The Jeffersons. Many people who worked on Married with Children also worked on The Jeffersons. Married with Children creators Ron Levitt and Michael G. Moy, as well as Married with Children producers John Maxwell Anderson, Kim Weisskopf, Sandy Sprung, and Marcy Vosburgh wrote and produced The Jeffersons in the early to mid-80s. Garrett Morris, who played Russ in The Poker Game and Requiem for a Dead Barber, and Erwin Keyes, who plays Mr. Hugo and Peggy Sue Got Work, both also guest starred on The Jeffersons in multiple episodes. Even though we see part of the wall behind the TV and Peggy turns 300, Change for a Buck is the first time we get to see the wall behind the TV in its entirety. While at the hospital waiting for Al to get out of surgery and a little off the top, Peggy calls Marcy and mentions in an episode of Geraldo talked about how men leave their wives for IHOP waitresses. Cliff Bemis, who played the termite boss in Season 2's The Great Escape and would return to Married with Children 3 seasons later to play Al's father in Requiem for a Chevyweight Part 1, was IHOP's spokesperson at the time. The Santa dress Marcy wears in The Worst Noel may be the same red dress Katie Sagal wore when she posed as Peggy for the TV Guide December 12, 1992 issue. Larry Hankin, who played Marie in Sofa So Good, would make his first appearance as Mr. Heckles on Friends 10 months after the airing of this episode. The ending of Honey, I Blew Myself Up, where Bud and Kelly come home with a birthday gift for Al, correctly guessing that they are the pants that he is currently wearing and they both leave, is one of the only endings after Season 3 that was not edited down to the original ending credits to DVD. The ending can still be found on the Mill Creek Season 8 DVD. The book Al reads to help him grow and harvest the apple, Farmer Iggy's Almanac, and How Green Was My Apple, was mentioned when Al begins to grow crops in the backyard in Season 5's Wabbit season. Wham-O, the toy company Bud tells the bodyguard he may mistake him for something from, in Valentine's Day Massacre, invented the hula hoop and frisbee. Bud's date, Lisa Pruner actress and Get Out of Dodge Stephanie Rydell, dated David Faustino in real life the time this episode aired. Being a part of the pop trio Wild Orchid, her bandmate Fergie appeared on the show 3 episodes later in Nooner or Later as Anne. In Field of Screams, Al tells Marcy that Al is the first word in Alamo after she tells him that the factory deal was made through town hall meetings and unmarked bills. When Peggy reminds him that we lost the Alamo, he tells her nobody remembers that. This is a reference to the Texan soldiers shouting, "Remember the Alamo!" as they went after the Mexican soldiers during the Battle of the Alamo, a battle during the Texas Revolution in 1836. The surprise attack, which lasted 18 minutes, took place during the Battle of San Jacinto, became the Deceive Battle in the Texas. In the Darcy Files, the jersey Jefferson is wearing when he shows up for the baseball game is for the Kansas City Monarchs. The Kansas City Monarchs was a black baseball league that produced more black baseball players than any other black baseball league. The guy in the biker vest who throws Bud across the shoe store when him and Kelly tried to cut in front of him in line in Nooner or Later was played by Peter Steinfeld. He previously appeared on Married with Children as the bodyguard in Season 3's Life's a Beach and as actor Rock Turberman in Season 6's Kelly Does Hollywood Part 2. In Ride Scare, the carpool representative Naomi actress Sandra Taylor was a penthouse pet in 1991 and appeared in Playboy in 1995. Another penthouse pet and Playboy feature, Terry Weigel, also appeared on Married with Children as Jade in 4 episodes. The legend of Ironhead Haynes is the last appearance for No Man member Roger. It is unknown if they were going to bring Roger back since this is also Barney's final appearance. But whether this was planned or not, a month after the airing of this episode, Roger actor Chris Collins passed away. Assault and Batteries aired during Fox's May 1994 sweeps for the television network Nielsen ratings Foxorama. The episode was presented in anaglyphic 3D, with kits including 3D glasses being available to buy at 7-Elevens participating in the event. While running around the couch on her sugar rush and Al goes deep, Marcy says, "Gee, I wonder what's on TV. It's Sunday. Oh no, Carlin's on." The George Carlin Show, which started airing 4 months before this episode's airing in January 1994. Married with Children was its lead-in. Travis James, the host of the game show that Kelly goes on and Kelly Knows Something, is played by Todd Christensen, who was best known at the time for being on the Los Angeles Raiders as a tight end from 1979 to 1988, after which he went on to become a sports commentator. His son later on revealed that every time Kelly Knows Something airs, his father receives residuals of $1.60.